women, I urge you to interrupt your daughter's regularly scheduled program of celebrity faces cupcake with makeup, sweetly feeding your baby girls frosted cover bites of deception until they get cavities in their relationship with God, being led astray by the likes of Beyonce's, Jay's, Kanye's, and Kim K's, and pray for Christ to crush those American idols. Move them out the way, removing every fragment left over that may cause decay in their mouthpaste words of wisdom of Christ. So when they're confronted with images of twisted truth like I was born this way, pray the Holy Spirit with God gag the lies and be the lie detector so they can know the truth of Scripture. Picture 1 Corinthians 7:31. Teach them that this world is passing away, so don't hold on to it along with everything therein that entices them to turn away from God, like Taylor Swiftly writing love songs to awaken lust that should be asleep on their iPod, blasting the tunes of Lady Gaga, grooming your baby girls to the rhythms of don't be a drag, just be a queen like Vashti. And Esther 1:19, who refused to submit to her king, was sadly booted from the kingdom because she refused to display her beauty is not everything, and the world sells sex like tailor-made suits fit for your girl's body type, size, zero, how low can you go? Throw up your stomach content so people can be content with your skeleton frame. The bigger, the less attractive, but if you're slender, maybe you'll be more attractive, but the only thing they're attracting is low self-esteem when they don't esteem Christ higher than their appearance of women. You should be tired of the liars on the radio, media, magazines, and movie scenes, steadily creeping, crouching, tiger, hidden, dragon, Satan, waiting to devour them and keep them falling asleep on Sunday sermons, challenging God's authority by disobeying the rules you set before they leave out the house just to break them during and after school hours, text messaging boys, not for homework, but to invite them into your home while you're at work so when you pull up to the front, the boy is sneaking out the back door and you're conversing with your daughter, assuming she's being upfront with you about being diligent in her studies when really she's studying how to become more astute in her sinful behavior because your daughter, along with your neighbor's daughter, and don't forget your goddaughter, act like they're God's daughters, really they're not. And forgive me. I know this topic is hot and I pray you won't be offended, my sisters, but that you'll pour into these young women who are lost and ask God to draw them to the cross, and maybe the girls I described in my rhymes are nothing like yours. Maybe they're really children of God or they aren't this way anymore, but I implore you that there are women from teens to 20-somethings and even older than me who need discipling. I said there are women from teens to 20-somethings and even older than me who need discipling, so disciple them in the gospel. Be like the apostles and teach them that they were created for the glory of God. Not like Nicki Minaj, who teaches them to be Barbies made of plastic anatomy, but be solid and firm as the rock you stand on. Jesus Christ is the only remedy for the sick souls, and the medicine of the Holy Spirit is what they need to repent and believe. The gospel needs to be preached in every city and every state, to every loved daughter and to every stray where Satan, the prince of the power of the air, is airing antichrist propaganda, trying to convince them that Jesus is not the only way to salvation. But be like Christ, be a light. Go grab the woman, the girl standing on the corner, sitting behind you in the church pew, Muslim, Jehovah Witness, Buddhist, or Jew, and give them the gospel because you can't afford to hesitate anymore. The message is really urgent, so I pray you get it. Now what are you waiting for?